term urban metabolism is not new. Ecologist Arthur Tansley was the first to mention the term already in 1935, talking about the energetic and material flows of the urban system. Analytical tools following this definition aimed at quantifying these flows. So looking at the urban environment as a system with inputs, outputs, and storage. More recently, the term was broadened, also incorporating the interconnection of flows within the urban environment and the closing of cycles in which waste of one process is input for another, like in nature. So with this approach, urban metabolism also relates to other concepts such as biomimicry by Janine Mendius and also Cradle to Cradle by Braungart and McDonald. Well, it's important to use this knowledge because the expression of these flows, the physical expression of these flows, are infrastructures. And the designing and embedding of infrastructures in the urban environment is one of our main responsibilities. So let me show you what I mean by these infrastructures using the Dutch situation. So remember this scheme, inputs, outputs, and the urban situation. So the same can be seen here. This is a drawing made by Dirk Simons in 2014 for the International Architecture Biennial of Rotterdam. And these shows the main Dutch flows and its infrastructures. So for water, main infrastructures are canals, water extraction facilities and purification installations, the drinking water supply network, but also sewers and wastewater treatment facilities. For energy, we have electricity generators or power plants, the electricity network, but also the heat network and pipelines for gaseous or liquid fuels. For traffic infrastructures, we have roads and bicycle and pedestrian infrastructures, public transport, and again, the canals for ships. For food and waste, we have farms, storage and supply facilities, but also solid waste collection, landfills, and separation and incineration facilities. So this shows there's a lot of infrastructure in the urban environment, and it's important to know all these infrastructures, how they work and how we can embed them. Also how we can interconnect them, so closing loops and making sure to reduce harmful inputs and outputs. In other words, reduce, reuse and recycle.